Hello, and this is Josh here from Poldtown FC. How's everyone doing? All right. Coming up tonight on Drummers Update 29. England win their group in the Euros. Scotland are out the tournament. Protest in London yet again. Bournemouth fixtures are released on Thursday at 9 in the morning. Harry Payday and Paul Carnival is cancelled due to COVID restrictions. And finally, again, Poldtown need your help on the 3rd of July at 9 a.m. at Satnam Black Gold Stadium for ground maintenance. So hello and welcome to Drummers Update with me, Josh, from Poldtown FC. Starting with England football team, our national football side. And England have won the group stage, the group D in the Euros, but Scotland finished fourth. That means Scotland are out of the tournament and they don't progress to the last 16 of the competition. Ow. You know what, I'm going to leave that. That really hurt me, that did. Can't open it. Ow. Alright, so that's good news. So England fixtures are to be confirmed. Try and get behind England. I mean, I know it's not been best at late, but, you know, at least something for everyone to do, though. But well done to England for getting through to the last 16 and winning the group. Play well, lads. And especially that Jack Grealish. He makes England different. He plays the game differently as well. So I think Jack had a good impact last night against the Czech Republic, which is fantastic news to see. Yeah. Okay, next. Protests in London yet again. That hurts me, actually, because I'm thinking to myself, well, if we have to go for another 4 weeks of restrictions, then we have to go for it. I know life's ruined, but it won't be for long. Now then, if Boris had extended it to after the 19th of July, then there'll be a bit more anger, because it means that the summer holidays are going to be ruined for children who have clearly worked hard at school and in education. Teenagers are going to be disappointed, because, well, they've worked hard and everyone's tried to go to school and work and stuff. This is not fair. And I partly agree with the protesters. I disagree with them. But it's because this new Delta variant and stuff is around at the moment, especially in the north of England. So that's partly why. But also the chance to get a vaccination as well. So, for example, myself, I've only got the one dose at the moment, still waiting for a second. Had mine back in May, so I've got another few weeks until I've got a second dose. Mum and Dad, for example, family and stuff, they've had both doses at the moment, so that's good news. That's mainly most of my family. One or two are still waiting for the first dose and first jab, but again, I can't say much on that one. But I can see why protesters are upset and they have to protest outside Parliament and Downing Street. But be careful out there, because you are going to get arrested by the Met Police. There are videos circulating online, you know, that are the police doing the right things? Are they not? And it is very, very difficult. It is really, really difficult for both sides. Are they doing it right or are they not? Yes, they're partly doing it right, but actually, maybe not. But what I say is, you know, don't protest. Just enjoy life for the moment. There's no point screaming outside Parliament. You might not get an answer, and you never do anyway. So it's a pointless journey to the capital, you know. So if you want to protest, fine, but there's no point. You won't be heard. What a waste of money. What an absolute waste of money for that. oh, you've got better things in life, you know. You've only got one life you have. It's not like the Cube, is it, really? With Philip Schofield? No. No, it's not. So, that's just how it is. But again, as I say, don't get frustrated with restrictions and protesters, because we will get through this as soon as we can. We will get through it. You see the green light from Boris, the UK Prime Minister. Yes. Yeah, okay. Okay, then Bournemouth fixtures are released on Thursday at 9 in the morning. So they will be released on Thursday morning at 9 in the morning. I'm hoping, but I've got a good prediction. I think Bournemouth will go to Sheffield United first on the 7th of August. If so, then I don't care because I'm not going. And actually, I've been to Bramall Lane before. Oh, Sheffield's not very good at all. And it won't be the shame. It won't be the same without Sheffield Wednesday anyway. So Sheffield's boring. Ugh. Yeah, sorry. Yuck. All they make is knives, forks and spoons. And, I mean, Bramall Lane's okay. But Sheffield's a bit rough. But I'm sure it's not meant like that, you know. Yorkshire, yeah, I don't know. Not really sure about that one, yeah. But I'm hoping Bournemouth will get some good fixtures and good starts. Hopefully some easier teams at first and then get on with the harder ones mid-season, hopefully. But again, we'll just have to see how depends how things go. At least Bournemouth don't have to play Watford and Norwich, though. No. Norwich, we always hate them now. Yep. After the 18th of January. Watford, they keep following us. And a little flares at the Vitality. Thank goodness we don't have to pull up with Watford and Norwich this season. Well, I mean, I was going to call them scummers, but I don't want to call them scummers. No. Losers. That would be good to put it. Yeah. All right, Harry Payday and Paul Carnival 2021 is cancelled due to COVID restrictions and the extension. So, on the 3rd of July, I was meant to be at the Harry Payday Carnival representing and getting publicity for Paul Town Football Club. Sadly, that's not going to happen. So, my next three carnivals that I've got lined up and the only ones that are going to be around in the south, nearest to me anyway, is Blandford, Ringwood and Gillingham. Blandford and Gillingham, North Dorset. Ringwood is, well, it's actually Hampshire, but I'd like to say it's just on the East Dorset border as well. So yeah, but Ringwood's always been Hampshire, so well, West Hampshire, the nice part of Hampshire, shall I say. No issues in Ringwood, no. Shh. Yeah, so they're the three carnivals, hopefully. It depends on Bournemouth and Paul Town fixtures as well. We'll have to see how things go. Paul Town fixtures, meanwhile, come out on the 22nd of July at 1 p.m. And that is just the latest I know at the moment. But dates are to be confirmed and they are subject to change. But it's a shame that we've lost Harry Payday and Paul Carnival this year because I'm really, really looking forward to it. I was really looking forward to it, honestly. But never mind. Just one of those things. Okay, and finally for this week, Paul Town FC need your help. On Saturday the 3rd of July at 9 o'clock in the morning at Tottenham, the Black Gold Stadium. There, they need your help on ground maintenance. It might be weeding. It might be painting fences. It could be getting ready for the season and stuff. And I just hope it's more frequent. And it is the timings of 9 a.m. till 12 o'clock in the afternoon. So it's 3 hours to get it done there. I might go, I might not. But I have to decide a lot nearer the time. As last time I went down there, It was okay, but it wasn't the best. But never mind. I think we're all learning and stuff, learning what to do and stuff. But yeah, that's just one of those things. But a lot to take on board, I think, after what's been a difficult few months with COVID misery. And that, I mean, it was Boris's fault in the first place, but probably not. No. Yeah. Okay, that's everything for now on Drummers Update 29. I will be back next Wednesday, the 30th of June, for Drummers Update 30. And that episode, the Drummers Update, will be the final episode, the final one. And it's going to be emotional as well. It will be emotional. I've enjoyed doing it, but due to other commitments and stuff, which I'm going to come on to next week, you know, I'll explain everything next week. It'll be easier. So we'll see how things go with that episode. Either it airs on time or not. Try and find some good facts to pull up for the final episode. And it will be an emotional send-off. It really would. Yeah. But I've enjoyed doing it for Paul Sound. But other commitments are coming on for me. And the restrictions are starting to go the right way. And the vaccine rollout as well, which is good. So this has always been a lockdown thing for me and stuff. But now things are changing. I just can't keep up with the episodes and commitments anymore. So that's just part of the reason. But as I say, I will explain everything on Drummers Update 30. Yeah. Okay, so thank you for watching Drummers Update 29, one of the episodes with Paul Sound Football Club, third party agreement. I'll see everyone soon. See everyone next weekend for Drummers Update 30. And again, it will be an emotional but final episode and send off. Thanks, everyone. See everyone soon. Good night.